is a file-based system. Yeah, so that for the file, it's more easy to management than the LVM partition. So that now we are using the kill count tool. So for the kill count tool, it's very easy to create an image. We just we have a base image before. Yeah, before you launch your production environment, you have to build up some very keen snapshot or keen image first, and then you can use that image to clone up to create another new machine image. And then for the snapshot, it's very easy. Just create this minus C is create, minus A is apply to apply which kind of snapshot. Delete is delete that snapshot from that file. Yeah, so that is the snapshot name and the file. So that is very easy to find. So for the common mechanism, it's just like a VM image. And then to build a snapshot, just pause that machine and then build snapshot. And then it will give you can just copy that build snapshot into a new image and then delete the snapshot. And then that's what the common is doing. Yeah, so for the virtualization, that's a very useful value. In the old time, you maybe have some hundred, yeah, for maybe a medium company, middle size company, maybe have like several hundred servers. Yeah, so that you have to so many people to maintain your server one by one and something. And so that when there's some the cost for those hardware servers, and then most of time is not most of the usage is not about the CPU or and then the RAM, the memory, it's a very low use. Yeah, when your system is not in a peak rate, most of the server I/O is also very low as well. So that's no meaning to have for you to keep lots of server at the same time, because for those kind of server, it's just for you to keep the peak out. Most of the usage of the services is only use about 20% of your whole server farm machine. Yeah, so that's why you can try if. Yeah, as the price of the server space is increasing in Hong Kong, so that you have to think about that how to use that rack, okay, to fit more image to use it, yeah, to utilize it. So that's why we using the P2V solution. That's from physical to virtualization. So that's very easy to use it when you have a one machine, okay, and you DD the image just as the as the previous talk, right? Use the DD is very useful. Just DD the whole image into a file. Just DD your whole hard disk into a file. And then you can just use that image to be as a virtual machine immediately after you do. Yeah, because that's KVM. So that it is hardware virtualization, so that you need not to do any kind of config, any kind of kernel configuration, any kind of kernel installation. You can just directly use your existing kernel to boot that machine. Yeah, so that's very easy.
But you use DD to clone the physical machine.
Yeah.
And how about the drivers?
Yeah, so that
you have installed a special driver for the physical machine.
Yeah, if your kernel is about 2.6, yeah, actually it's support for the QEMU. That's they are using QEMU driver. So that if your kernel is 2.6 already, that is support. If 2.4, that you have to be compiled. Yeah, that's right.
Does P2V support the Windows?
P2V is support Windows.
But if you upgrade your motherboard, the Windows need to be installed.
do this. Or if you are using business the MSDN image, the MSDN image it do not have such kind of stuff. Yeah, if you use the business, yeah, the MSDN, it will just ask you to reactivate that backhaul.
I remember if you change the motherboard, the Windows will boot to blue screen.
Boot to blue screen. Yes. Yeah, this is yeah for the business version. Yeah, okay. Because that's about the Windows server, so that I have no idea.
No.
How about the desktop environment? But if for desktop environment, for me actually, yeah, when a new computer comes, it will have an old OEM version of the Windows. I will wrap it up and then install the Linux and then put that Windows image into a VM. And then after that, I can clone that kind of VM into somewhere to help me to do some testing. Yeah. But you have to check in the license first. Yeah, if the license allows you for you to do it, then it's possible. So that when I want to switch from SAN to the KVM, then I have to do something because of the SAN has customized its own kernel, so that I have to reinstall the distro kernel first, and then to boot into the KVM. And then for the virtual box, okay, I can move virtual box and the VMware image into the KVM as well. It is very smooth. Yeah, no, there's nothing. You just need to convert that kind of image into the kernel. Do that. That's it. That's very easy to change it. Yeah. Yeah. For me, at first, I used the virtualization method in 2004 or something, and then I used VMware, and then after that, I changed all my VMware look into the KVM. It is very smooth to do it. That's nothing difficult. Yeah. So that you can find that passage on my blog. I have a passage say how to convert your VMware image into the KVM. Yeah, so that you can change it. Yeah. Okay. And then there's more tools called VIR. Yeah, because for the VMware and SAN, it has its own configuration. So that you have to use the VIRT goodness to convert that kind of XML file, the config file, into the VIRT readable format. And that's very convenient. We can just clone our basic image, the base image, into a new machine, or we can just use a VIRT install. It is a command VIRT install. It will help you to install the Ubuntu. Yeah, this is an Ubuntu command. When you are using the Ubuntu tools or Debian tools, Debian distribution, and then it provides a VIRT installation to help you very easy to build up a new Debian or a new Ubuntu without any setting, without any installation screen and something. It will just ask you to type this command. It will automatically to help you to install it in the background. Yeah, for the Red Hat, it has kickstart. You can use kickstart to do it. Yeah, but it's not so convenient than the Ubuntu and that base. Yeah, so that I can just use a VIRD installation. Okay. And then if I want to so that my host is Ubuntu. So if I want to install VBSD and other things, I have to have a CD and then use the VIRD manager to install, to have the installation screen. Yeah, to do the whole installation. That's the other method to do. Yeah. So that after this talk, and then I will show you in the demo how to do this kind of things. Okay. So live migration. So that's VB has talked about before, that asked about live migration. Yeah, this is one kind of live migration. So okay, let's back to here. For the live migration, what's the meaning of live migration? So that I have one VM in here, okay, and then this host, okay, has some problem. I have to switch off so that I can just copy the CPU instruction and then the memory into this machine, and then just about 1 second downtime, and then move it here, and then we start again, and then it will very smoothly to do the migration. Okay. So any question about this one? Yeah.
用中文嗰個 host 咧，你 migrate 一個去第二個咧，需唔需要identical 嘅 hardware
嘅？需唔需要 identical？
因為如果個 VMware 行咧就有 virtual device 噶嘛，咁但係如果係咁樣咧，係
冇你 VMware virtual device， 但係 KVM 係冇呢樣嘢嘅。KVM 冇呢樣嘢，你 virtual box 都有呢樣嘢，有個 virtual device 咁佢冇嘅。咁你其實可以直接咧，你啲 config 你兩邊擺曬，config 兩邊擺曬啦。你呢度佢有個 command 嘅，叫VIRSH 叫做 migration 咁樣，佢就可以由呢部機將你呢個行緊嘅 image 嗰啲 RAM 啊，嗰啲 CPU 嗰啲嘢就直接搬過嚟。咁你當然啦，你搬過嚟佢就會幫你停咗機先 ，pause 咗先，停咗之後抄過嚟就會著翻，入冇兩三秒到。咁呢度點做嘅咧？你一定個 image 要喺呢個位，係啦，你個 hard disk 嗰個 image 一定要喺呢個位，咁佢先可以做到啦。如果唔係你個 hard disk 擺喺呢度咧，即係個 image 擺喺呢度咧，你呢部色機佢攞唔翻㗎。
好似都得㗎。但係好似好嘥時間，因為佢要成個
唔係，因為你要成個 image 抄過去，就唔係 live 埋製作。
唔係，佢都係 live 嘅，但係就
佢會有單攤。
個單攤唔單攤，但係就好嘥時間，因為你 copy 嗰個。
啊，係啊，因為要 copy 曬過去。
即係 copy 嗰個名係會嘥，好
即係。我唔知而家個做法點，以前咧就咁樣係抄唔到落去嘅。
早兩年好似開始得，
但係因為而家我就唔知實質啦，呢個一年前仲係做。
我想問個問題，而家你有幾個 host 啊？咁其實個第一個 host 同第二個 host 個 hardware， 我意思係個 hardware 使唔使係？
哦，可以唔同㗎，可以唔同㗎。我哋嗰陣時，我哋嗰陣呢部係 server 嚟嘅，呢部 desktop 嚟嘅，跟住呢部係另外一部 desktop 嚟嘅。
所以相差好遠啦！如果 RAM 一個係四 G， 一個一 G，
唔係嗱嗱，你如果 RAM 咧，你就要計翻數啦。因為你如果呢度可能我夠 RAM， 呢度可能四 G RAM， 所以我開四部。咁你買機過嚟，你呢部得兩 G 嘅，你唔可以買機曬四部嘅，佢會死嘅。係啦，即係總言之 ，RAM 就最好一樣大啦，因為你係諗住係做 high availability 嘛。
嗯。
咁你一定係，我呢部機壞咗，我熄咗就唔會影響呢兩部，咁亦都可以將啲嘢抄曬過嚟，咁就成個 services 就唔影響啦。係啦。OK。So if you want to use a live migration one year before that, you have to put your image here. Otherwise, there's no way to connect between two machines to do the migration. But give me a minute. Yeah, a lot. Yeah. But long say that now that can be when your image in here, you do the live migration, that it will help you to automatically copy bit by bit to here until it finished, then you can switch it off. Yeah. Okay. So, but before that, we have to put every image in here so that. Any limitation or no
additions?
Yeah, I've just tried this. Yeah, because Windows. Okay. So he's Kyle will say that Windows is. Yeah. Any other? Hi.全部用 KVM 就可以直接過到，但如果你係有啲係 send 嘅話，唔得。
但係我見就係、是，如果你用平時 desktop 嘅話，佢嗰、那個GUI 嗰個 format 都係
係佢一定係OBF 噶嘛。但係咧，如果你話我會一用，我會點咧？我會轉咗做 VDMK 咯 ，VMDK 嚟
VMDK
係啦 ，VMDK 我會用曬 VMDK 噶。
唔係佢嗰個係實際上都係佢入邊係包住一個。VMDK，
係，
跟住再加一個，
然後出面有個 config file
嘅，
係啊，有個 config file。其實你可以用嗰、那個QEmail 嗰個咩，頭先個咩 VIRT boot 咧，拆翻開去之後就做到啦。係啊，要做啦。
我幫你，咪
係啦，你 yeah, so that now we are going to see a demo。
新嘅零件，零件，呢個俾咗你啦。
呢個，我著得啦。
拜拜你。
呢個嘛
嚇，個布陣
嘅，係啊，攞到手機啊，又喺山外，
幾好啊！
其實有冇咩限制啊？如果我由 VMware 轉做去 KVM 嘅形式，
嗱 VMware 轉做 KVM 形式，你如果 VMware 你裡面係 hardware virtualization 就冇限制嘅，直接過到嘅。但係啊，你 VMware 有兩隻方面噶嘛，一隻咪dynamic， 即係佢都係 dynamic growth 啦。但有一隻是一個大的 file 裝曬咁多嘢，有一隻可以將佢啲 file 逐個兩極兩極咁斬細嘅，兩極兩極咁斬細嗰隻要首先合翻埋咗一個先，先可以 connect 到。如果唔合埋咧，就做唔到啦。
哦，仲有，如果你 Windows 機咧，你裝咗 Virtual IoT driver 先。
係，Windows 機要裝 Virtual IoT，
同埋 Win 七之後就可能會方便啲，之前嗰啲啲 driver support 就差啲。
XP 係。但你講就嗰，如果講緊 Windows Server 2008係 work 嘅，
2007，即係 Windows Server 之後
嗰陣，係啦 ，Windows Server 嗰陣係 work 嘅，因為我哋嗰陣試到係 Windows Server。
我想問咧，就係我行 VMware， 佢行啲 virtual， 例如本 network 卡係 AMD 某一個 model 或者 Intel 某一個 model 嘅，
哦嗰個唔得
啊嘛。咁轉咗 KVM 咁點咧？即係會唔會有問題？
轉咗 KVM 嚟 virtual device 應該冇問題嘅喎，佢 connect。即係佢頭先嗰個 XML 嗰度咧，佢 connect 到㗎，係啊。但係你如果 specify 某隻牌子，可能唔得，係啦。你可能轉翻 universal， 轉翻 universal 先，係啦。因為佢都有個，即係你就算嗰、那個叫呢個，就算 virtual box 佢都有幾隻㗎嘛，有幾隻俾你揀㗎嘛。你換翻 Intel 先，換翻 Intel 就一定 work 嘅，係啦，換翻 Intel。So we are just demoing the VIRT, the VIRT, the VIRT. more connection. So that yeah, for here is now is my machine is just all in one machine. Okay. And then but for the real usage, yeah, your KVM host maybe in the server room. And then how do I can use my client machine and then to connect to the server by using this one. I can just really use the app connection and then the hypervisor is here and then connect between SSH and then to make the connection then very easy. You will everything will be full the SSH to connect to your virtual host in the server room. So then you just send this one. Okay. Yeah, so you can now see that there's two machines. Okay. That's very easy that you can see the things in here, it's just like the VMware
stuff. These two hosts are back at your lab or back in your office? Right?
No, that's all in your machine. This one is very, very good. Yeah. Two CPUs in there? Yeah, that's core. That's still core. That's still core. Yeah, that's still core. Yeah, that's very cool for this one. That's very cheap. This the motherboard with the CPU is just about 800 dollars. Yeah, it's sell. But that's enough. That's very enough. Because this machine is faster than my server in my home. Yeah. Yeah, so that for the slide before I talked about how to create the image, we can use the clone name, yeah, and then we can also use the VRT minus installation installer, and then of course we can use the directly to use the CD-ROM to do the installation. Yeah, that's why the GUI method is much better than the console, because I need not to use a VLC to connect back to this machine so that's why we call the server. So you can up to 2 available because my one is too core, thin core. So that I can set the NAT or bridge network. Yeah, for the bridge network, you have to set your bridge network at your /etc/network/interface first to start the bridge network. Otherwise, you cannot. You have no way to use it. Yeah. So this is the MAC address. But for me, I will use some write some script to help me to generate a MAC address, because for my router there's a DNS server, so that I can use that MAC address to assign the IPs to me. So that's our MAC address here. Okay. I can continue. So that's what it was. Okay, please. So actually for the virtualization, it's just same as use a very normal computer. And then so that you can see it here.
So we'll be in control alternate.
Aye. server, that the CPU load is something. And then for this one, actually, I'm also running. Yeah, so that you can see that it is very fast. It's faster than the virtual box. Yeah, that's my experience. The KVM is actually faster than the virtual box.
KVM is faster than ESX? Faster than the end.
Yeah.
There's a industry standard comparison. They call it SpecVert, SPECVERT, and that's the independent testing. And they say it's KVM outperforms ESX very easily.
Okay. So that is very good. For you to use the KVM. And of course there's a lot of more virtualization method now on the market. Something like OpenStack that you send, and also there's something called OpenVSET. Yeah, because now OpenVSET is some kind of host company are using OpenVSET, and then the container. But for the container and then OpenVSET, this is a different method. This is not the real virtualization. It's just some kind of sharing. Yeah.
Yeah, with containers, you can only virtualize just Linux.
Yeah.
Or the same. It's like you can't run Windows.
They're using the same kernel, so that there's no way for you to run Windows.
Different operating system. Yeah, so the same operating system as the host.
Yeah, that's right. Actually, for the KVM, the disadvantage is that you can see it is good for the environment that is not using the VDSL agent. The problem of nowadays distribution. Because the default, if you just think about that, you should have the VDSL agent. So that for the Fedora and the Ubuntu, the desktop version, it will just help you to install all kind of event in it. So that will make your virtual machines very slow. If you are not because if you are using GROM, that's the problem, that they will think that you are using VDSL. So that's the problem on KVM. That's the only problem. Yeah, so that when you want to use, so that is very slow when you are using desktop environment. For the window, I think it's better. Because it still have the low end volume. For the new distribution of the using the ground view on something that it is very high end, so that that's not the problem. But you use a QEM. Yeah.
Are you talking about a VD?
Yeah, VDSL.
Oh.
Yeah, because for the KVM, it.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
So if you are not using ground, you are using
LSDE or it's just fine. Or you are using GOM2 base or